Amateurs show up when they feel like showing up and they don't set deadlines. Whereas professionals show up when they don't feel like it and they set and keep deadlines. But showing up isn't enough. Hey, it's Lucas Grobot and you're listening to Weaver and Loom. Like me, are probably approaching your craft, your work, your dreams, your goals, your art as a professional. You're showing up on a daily basis when you don't feel like it. You're showing up when you're sick, when you're tired, when you have a thousand other things to do, and you're saying, I am going to commit myself to my craft, to my goals, to my business when it doesn't feel good. And I'm going to set deadlines. And I'm going to keep those deadlines, even if it means a sleepless night. I, like you, and you, like I know what that's like. I know what it's like to finally say, you know what? I am committing to this. I don't just hope that it works out, but I'm committing. And I'm putting my time, my effort, my energy, my labor, my life resource into this craft, into this goal, into this business, into this dream. And I'm going to see it through to the end. But maybe you are like me, and there's times as you're showing up daily, day in, day out, putting in those reps, committing to your craft, committing to your work, that you wonder, is this going to produce the results and the outcomes that I want, whether today, tomorrow, or 10 years from now? Am I taking the right path, the right journey, or should I bail and switch? Maybe you're wondering, will this make the impact that I want to make in the world? I'm showing up. I'm committed. I'm doing the work that's necessary, but am I doing the right work? Am I doing the work in the right way? See, when I started this podcast, which was back in June or July of 2018, I committed to myself saying, okay, I'm doing this. I'm doing this podcast. I'm committing to the process. Towards the fall of 2018, I had some hiccups with sound stuff, and I didn't have everything in place. So I took some time and I built out some infrastructure so that I could have everything in place to be able to move forward into 2019. And when I started this back in June, July of 2018, I told myself and I told others, I'm going to put my head down and I'm going to plow forward. And I'm going to lay brick after brick after brick. And I'm not going to think about whether it's good, whether it's bad. I'm not going to evaluate. I'm not going to think about, well, should I jump ship? Should I do this? Well, it's not working. Maybe I should change. I said, I'm not going to do any of that. I'm going to do 100 episodes. And after I put 100 reps in, 100 episodes, I'm going to lift my head up. I'm going to look around and I'm going to evaluate my work so that I can learn and move forward. Because here's the thing. We do not grow. We do not learn from experience. We do not grow and learn from merely putting in the reps. We learn and we grow from putting in the correct reps, the correct way. When you go to the gym, it's not just doing a lot of running or doing a lot of reps, doing a lot of cleans. It's having the right program to reach you to your goals. And that takes changing your program and stopping and evaluating, okay, where am I? How do I move to the next level? What is the next level? How do I refine my work? So we don't learn from experience, but we learn from experience that we pause and we reflect on. And it is that process of taking a step back from your work, pausing, reflecting on it, evaluating it, critiquing it, seeking out constructive and critical feedback, and then applying the insights that we learned from our evaluation and our reflection onto our future work. Otherwise, we would be like what most of the world is, the definition of insanity, doing the same things over and over and over and over and over again, expecting different results. And when we put in the reps year after year, and we never pause to evaluate those reps, the quality of those reps after we've reached a certain volume, so that we can improve upon and say, this is working and this isn't working. If we never stop to evaluate, we will essentially just be putting in mindless reps, hoping and dreaming and praying that one day those reps will somehow magically produce the results and the outcomes that we started on this journey hoping to achieve. So I'm at the point in this podcast, episode 113, even as I was sitting down to produce this podcast, I thought, wow, 113. I did not think that I would ever get to 113. And I've been putting out 5 episodes a week for the past 13 weeks. From episode 40 to episode 113, I've put out 5 episodes a week without fail. And, you know, 10 episodes, 12 episodes into it, I was like, oh man, what am I going to say next? And here there's now been, what have that 60, 73 episodes nonstop. But I promised myself that after 100 episodes, I would pause, I would reflect, and I would refine. And I do feel like I am at a place where there are certain things that I want to refine about my process, about the podcast, about the content, not changing it, not going in a totally different direction, but asking, how can I improve? How can I take this to a deeper level and add more value to you, the listener, those who are showing up day in, day out? And I am so honored and humbled that there are hundreds of people who are showing up, some every day, some a couple days a week, some maybe once a week. You can't really be sure with the podcast analytics, but there are so many people that are showing up at this door. You who are listening to this, showing up at the door day in, day out, and listening to this podcast. And that means so much for me. And I want to improve the quality, the experience, the value, the content of this podcast for you. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm taking this next month, in the month of November 2019, and I'm not stopping. I'm still performing interviews. I'm still going to be putting out multiple episodes a week, probably 2 to 3 episodes a week. I am just taking myself off of the hook for this next month of producing 5 episodes a week. I'm taking myself off that hook. But it's not because I'm giving up. It's not because I'm like, I'm tired. It's not because, I don't have anything to say. Actually, I'm looking at a whiteboard right now that is like 2 meters by 3 meters. And it is jam-packed full of things to say. So it's not that I don't have anything to say or that I'm out of ideas, but I feel like I want to refine those ideas for you, for the audience, for you who's listening to me today, so that it's better, so that I'm serving you in a deeper and more meaningful way. So I'm taking myself off the hook. Why? To reflect, to study, to analyze, to say, what am I doing well? What am I doing wrong? Where do I need to build out infrastructure so that I can scale what I'm doing, so I can go deeper with you who's listening to this today? And how can I do that? So that's what I'm going to be doing for the month of November. Don't worry, content will still be coming out at a mind-breaking speed, just maybe not 5 days a week. So this actually does give you an enormous opportunity to go back and catch up on some of the episodes that you maybe have not had the opportunity to listen to. Because I talk to a lot of people who say, you put out so much content. You're putting out an episode a day. I'm not able to listen to an episode a day. I'm so far behind on my podcast listening. This is a great opportunity for you to do 2 things. I have 2 action points. 1, if you're like, no, don't stop. I want more content. Go back and listen to some of those previous episodes because, man, there's so much. I'm going to be going back and reflecting. I'm like, okay, what did I say over the last 70 episodes? I feel like there's a couple books in there that I want to be able to structure out and refine and publish, because the content and the quality of this last 70 episodes, especially, it is so great. I'm excited about it. Second, for this month, the month of November, I want to challenge you, whatever craft, whatever work you are pushing forward into, to take some time and slow down your reps. Take some time and take a couple steps back and begin to reflect and evaluate where are your strengths, where are your weaknesses, and how can you build and grow? How can you grow stronger in your strengths? And how can you either minimize or hire out for those weaknesses, or figure out what can I do to shore those weaknesses up? Is it an issue, or do I need to double down on my strengths? So take some time, reflect on your work, reflect on your processes this month, the month of November, as you lead in to 2020. It's only 2 months away, 2020. Take some time so that come December, you know how you want to be building. You're not deciding January 1st, but come December 1st, you know, okay, this is the direction that I'm going, and you can begin to lay those building blocks in place to launch into this new season with strength and confidence. Number three, I said two, but number three, if you need help doing that, please reach out. I would love to help you. That is all for today. I already gave you three action points. The fourth action point, if you're like, I need more content, go and get my book, Anchor the Discipline to Stop Drifting. It will help you hone in your vision and place actionable steps to your dreams so that you will reach your goals. As always, I'm Lucas Grobot. You are a change maker, and this is where destiny is woven.